Good morning, everybody. Well, it's morning here in Sydney, so I'm filming this, but yeah, so as you can see from the title, I'm going to be doing a season switcheroo. I have recently made a video on some of my secondhand shoes that I got while I was thrifting or buying from eBay or the Facebook marketplace, but that collection has since grown. And I do have some shoes that I want to bring home to the Philippines to give to my sisters-in-law and maybe, like, I don't know if any of my cousins or nieces have the same shoe size as I do, because I have a relatively small feet. So I am a size US 6. Here in Australia, it's pretty much the same 6 or European 37. So most of my cousins have larger feet, or I know my sister-in-law, one of them has the same shoe size as I do, but the others don't, so we'll see. So anyway, I'm going to show you my entire collection of shoes, and then I'm going to tell you which ones are going to go into the giveaway pile, which ones are going into the into storage for a next winter or next autumn, and then which are coming out now that it's spring and coming into the summer. So I'm gonna do this a little bit of vlog style, so yeah, let's go. Okay, you guys, so here is my entire collection of shoes. Those boots there under that rack are also mine, and there's quite a few in that storage box from IKEA that I will now be showing you. Okay, let's get started. Okay, so I'm gonna start off by opening this storage box and then showing you what's inside, so that I can empty it and put out the ones that are coming out for this season of spring and summer, and then placing in here the shoes that won't be used during this time. Okay, let's get into it. All right, so in the storage, I have these patent croc style boots from Public Desire, and these are on my eBay for resale. I've only used them a couple of times. You can tell by the wear under that it hasn't been used much. I'm just really not a heel person, and look at the size or the height of this heel. Yeah, so I'm not really a heel person, but because these are blocks, I can tolerate them. But just look at how pretty this is. So if you're in Australia, or if you're happy to pay international shipping and you want these boots, go ahead into my eBay account. It's in the description bar down below. Okay, these clogs, those, by the way, are size 37s. I don't know if you can actually see the sizing from there, but anyway, now these clogs are by Nordic Fusion. I have never worn them. I bought them secondhand as well. They were unworn when I bought them as well, so it's never been worn. I thought that because these were leather, I could actually get them to be a little bit, well, there's a little bit of dirt from, like, I guess walking around. So these are size 36, which is a size smaller than what I normally wear. And because of that, I thought that I could make these get loose because it's leather anyway, but I just don't have the patience to break them in. So these are also in my eBay. Okay. These are Whitner shoes, and they are beautiful, like, woven shoes that have cut outs. You can tell from there. These are size 37s. I thrifted these from Vinnie's, and they are also on my eBay and Depop. Okay, now these are Lacoste shoes. They're trainers. Pretty cool. I've only worn them a few times. They are size 38. I did also thrift this. I think there was was $25 when I thrifted this. Still in really good condition, but they're a size too big for me, so I am actually bringing this home to Manila to give to one of my sisters-in-law. Okay, Charles and Keith loafers. Okay, now these ones, I've only worn a few times as well. I bought them brand new when I was in Manila. Really, really nice loafers. I just don't wear them often enough. These are also size 37s, and they are in my Depop and eBay. So those are being resold. These are espadrille wedges. They're quite high. They're about 5 inches high. From here to here, which is one of the reasons why I don't wear them often. I bought the second hand from eBay. It was never worn when I bought it. These are size 37s, but yeah, because of the height and they are quite heavy, because of the platform, I don't really wear them. I've only worn them once, to be honest. So I am reselling them over at eBay and Depop. No other item is going to be resold. Everything else is either going to be given or be kept. These are, again, mock croc boots. They are from Dazzy or Daisy, D-A-Z-I-E. I got them from, I believe it was ASOS. I think it was ASOS. Either ASOS or The Iconic. They are about 3.5 inches high, almost 4. These, for some reason, are more comfortable to wear than the other booties, which is why I decided to keep these instead of the other one. Also, with its color, it elongates my legs when I wear them, as opposed to the other ones, the patent leather ones. So these ones I'm keeping, but they are staying inside the storage because I wouldn't be using them for this season. So staying here. Okay. Now these I haven't worn just yet. I got them from TK Maxx. These are Bueno shoes. When I found them, I kind of thought of them as very similar to the Everlane Day gloves, I think they're called. But this one has these really nice sort of like pattern here. And they're really pretty on the feet. They're very, very comfortable. It's quite soft. Soft leather here. So there you go. It's made in Turkey. So these are coming out for the summer and the spring. These are my other Charles and Keith shoes. I love these white loafers. They go well with my jeans and any of my other clothing. I love the square toe on them. And these are also coming out for the spring and summer. I've got the paddings of my, what do you call this? My blazers in here. I don't know why. Now in this little plastic is a pair of stiletto shoes. These are from GB and they are a local Filipino brand. I have had these shoes since 2016, if I am not mistaken. And what I like about these is that these are elastics. And they wrap around your legs quite nice, like an X. So if you imagine that those are my legs, they kind of look like that on your legs. So they're really sexy to look at. And as you can see, they've had quite a bit of wear on them. So these are kept in here for special occasions because I don't really go out in the evenings. That would justify me having this out, but it's very, very accessible anyway inside my closet. Okay, now let's look at the other shoes outside of the storage. All right, so I think I'm gonna start with my Doc Martens. Here we go. I have here a pair of Doc Martens. These are the 1460 Culbert Black. These are the Snowplow WP or Winter Grip. Okay, so I've worn this during the winter, and they're obviously been stored away because I'm gonna show you one of them. They're like the mono looking 1460, so it doesn't have the yellow stitching, it has a black one. But you can tell that these are lined with Sherpa, I think is what it's called. So very definitely for the winter season. What I've done is I've conditioned it with the Doc Martens Wonder Balsam before putting them away so that they don't dry up in storage. And I just put them back in this their original packaging. I bought this brand new from the Iconic, I think it was. It might have been ASOS. I got it from ASOS. They were on sale for like 50% off, and I couldn't resist. I had an addiction with Doc Martens. Anyway, now these are definitely staying with me, so that's why I put them. I have put them in their box again. Okay. These Doc Martens 1460 cherry boots are going to go into storage because I don't think I'll be wearing them anytime soon. I can still wear them now because it's still a little bit cold, but I haven't. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put them into storage. Do a little bit of a wipe down before that because it's a little bit dusty. But again, I have also conditioned this with a Wonder Balsam before I place them in there. Okay, so that is going into storage. Okay, next. Oh, by the way, those are like 10-year-olds when I lived in Singapore. These are Timberland, the 6-inch boots. I got the second hand from U-Turn Vintage. You can still see the pricing at the bottom. It says $59. These originally retail for $200 something. And what I've done is just I've bought insoles for them because the insides were already like not really good, but the soles and the outside are still quite perfect. So these are also going into storage because I don't think I'll be using them anytime soon. And anyway, where I store this box is very, very accessible. So if I ever do need them later on, I can always just take them back. Okay, next. These are lovely Doc Martens as well. I forget what they're called. Might have it in here. Yeah, this is the Bentley Doc Martens. So they're like brogue type shoes, but are high tops. And again, I got the second hand. I believe it was from eBay that I got this from. I do like the floral pattern inside, but I use this more for like work when I'm wearing trousers. So these are going to go into storage as well for now. Then I've got here, these are quite new. These are my, what are they called? Flora Chelsea boots. Also Doc Martens. I got this recently. Also secondhand. I paid $85 for them. And they're so, like, they were never worn. You can totally tell. These are staying out because I still like to wear, like, my skirts with tights. And these look really nice with them. And I'll show you a photo of me wearing them with tights. So these are staying out. Okay. Doc Martens poly T-bar in suede blue. Secondhand as well. These are staying out. Okay. More Doc Martens. These are Doc Martens sandals. What are these ones called? Don't know what style they're called. I think, here we go. These are called the Voss, and it's got like that oxblood color, so these are staying out for sure. Summer. These are the Blair Doc Martin sandals. They look white on camera, but they are actually light blue. Like, I'll put it against the white, you can tell the difference. Okay, staying out. Now that it's getting warmer, it's okay to wear those. Okay, now we go on to my Converse. Recently got this from Depop, Converse Houndstooth High Tops. I think I paid $30 plus shipping. Really cute, got that pink lining at the bottom, staying out. Vans high top leather sneakers. Got this from U-Turn Vintage. I paid, how much were you? I think they were $29. So staying out for sure. Lacoste brogues, used for, well, usually for work. So these are actually going to go into storage because I haven't actually reached for them, but I can totally wear that anytime. Okay, Lacoste high tops. Haven't reached for these for a while, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to give this away to my my sister-in-law when I go home to the Philippines. Okay, Converse regular chucks, staying. Had this for 5 years, it's not going anywhere. Lacoste blue and white sneakers, staying. Recently thrifted Jeffrey Campbell heeled brogues, staying. I think I paid $16 for those. Recently thrifted Oxblood loafers, staying. Okay, I have another pair of loafers here. These are from, I don't know how to say that name, I think it's called Pour La Victoire, maybe. These are snake skin loafers. I'm gonna get that out of there, out of the box, so that I can actually see it and wear it, because I haven't been able to wear it because I don't know where it is. Actually, I'm gonna put my Lacoste in that box so that it's kept nice, and then put them into storage. The only runners that I own now, these are my Adidas Ultra Boosts. I've had them for almost 2 years now. It's been my go-to shoes for all the charity runs that I've been doing, so these are definitely staying out. My Birkenstocks, definitely staying out. Recently got this secondhand from Shop Opportunity on Instagram. She was doing an Insta story sale, and I thought that these were perfect for the summer. It's still quite cold outside, but this week it's gonna start to warm up. Like, there's a day that's actually gonna be in the 30s. So I think I'll keep this out for now. And yeah, now I do have these, which I wore to work. These are nude stilettos from Novo. And as you can see, they are in storage because I haven't been wearing these, but I want to keep this out because they look really nice on jeans. So keeping that out. And of course, this one has got sentimental value, so it's not going anywhere. These were my wedding shoes. I bought these from ASOS. They have glittery heels and silver toes, so they're not going anywhere. I do have a few more of these shoe boxes, and I'm going to utilize that for the other shoes that I'm going to put into storage so that they don't catch dust. But yeah, that is my entire shoe collection. Oh, here. My Everlast rubber slippers that I wear around the house. And as you can see, I've got like these houndstooth tights on. I'll be doing an OOTD with it a little bit later. So, yes. Okay, so that was the entirety of my shoe collection, from boots to slippers. And as you can see, a lot of them are now secondhand. And I've been passing on some of my shoes as well to my friends, and now that I'm going home to the Philippines, I'll be passing on some to family members as well. If you have any questions on me, on my shoe collection, on me buying secondhand shoes, and what I look for when I do so, leave them in the comment section down below, and I'd be more than happy to address that. If you have any questions outside of that, or any suggestions on what videos you want me to make, then please leave them again in the comment section down below. Thank you. Bye.